¿Este tabaco está para dormir?
No. No, no. Es que eso lo otro, ahí están uno. Nosotros le pusimos unos redondeles para.
Por el bien.
Para, no, para entre comillas, evitar que paratriosis de aquel lado se nos pase para acá. Pero eso es entre comillas.
Oh, okay. So that was part of the defense that they were using for the bacteria, those cloths there. That was for prevention from it coming in from the sides.
The other thing, too, is it gives you detection, because what will end up happening is because it travels via airborne insect, the insects will actually run into the tenting. Okay, and they're not that bright. They don't go, oh, I got to just go over this. They actually run into it, and they drop there. So what will end up happening is they'll actually spray those tents with insecticide. So rather than applying the insecticide to the crop, you can actually apply it just to the tent.
So probably it was getting infected by the what was ever growing over there, maybe?
Who knows? I don't know how far it travels. I mean, this is why we have agronomists.
Yeah, but that's what the intention was. But
the intent is to do that. And I was telling some of the other guys, you know, when you go to fields, you'll find that they'll use natural bricks, like down at the end there. You can see that looks like sugar cane over there. So that would be a very natural crop to use as a windbreak, as a wind shear.
Yeah.
Because it grows high and it grows thick and it grows dense and it's cheap and it doesn't require much maintenance for you to keep a.
You guys can see here, just you can see where the flower has been topped.
Right, you can see the topping on this very clearly on this plant.
Okay. So you're on the second priming. So that's. Let's see, second prime. They're doing primings every 8 days.
In this field?
Yeah.
Okay.
So they're doing, so that was 16 days ago, and then this was cut at 50 days.
Normalmente, nosotros agarramos y capamos, no sé si capar, capar o deflorar, o quitar la yema, ¿verdad? Eso, cuando el tabaco de nosotros tiene más o menos unas 16 horas. 16 horas.
Como 50 días.
Normalmente, este tabaco anda entre 55, de 50 a 55 días ya para comenzarlo a cortar. Ya, en este tipo de variedad. Hay otras variedades que son más tardadas, como el Corojo 2006, eso se dilata 75 días para que ya fisiológicamente esté maduro, pues, y comenzar a agarrarnos. Este tabaco, si ustedes ven, ya todo está casi de corte. ¿Por qué no lo he hecho? Por el tiempo, la cantidad de personal, ¿verdad? Que porque tenemos 34 manzanas, la producción es bastante y no me da chance. Entonces tengo que, todo este tabaco estuviera dentro de la casa. ¿Ah?
Hay
mucho que hacer, correcto.
Yeah, because this is all filler tobacco, you can see it isn't tended the same way. Like a filler crop, they would have been pulling all of this off. They wouldn't let this happen on a wrapper crop. But on a filler crop, it isn't as critical. On a wrapper crop, you would pull off all the sucker leaves because you wouldn't want any energy to go to it. I want you guys to put your hands on it, and you can feel how much gum there is on a leaf. Can you feel how sticky it is and how gooey it is? Right.
I noticed that even in
right. The right. Well, we call that grasso, fat, essentially.
Es lo que decía. El corte transversal se deja, se riega y comienzan a nacer.